Welcome to a lesson on simplifying fractions. In this lesson, we will define a simplified fraction and also simplify fractions. A simplified fraction is a fraction that has no common factors other than one between the numerator and denominator. So looking at the basic fraction of 1/2 shown here, where the rectangle represents one whole, 1/2 is a simplified fraction because the only common factor between 1 and 2 is 1. We also know that 1/2 is equivalent to 2/4 shown here. We know they're equivalent because the same amount is shaded, but for 2/4, we're using smaller parts or pieces of the whole to represent the same amount. 2/4 is not simplified because notice 2 and 4 share a common factor other than 1, they share a common factor of 2. For some additional examples, 7/8 is a simplified fraction, or a fraction written in lowest terms, because the only common factor between 7 and 8 is 1, and the fraction of 4/6 is not simplified, are written in lowest terms because 4 and 6 have a common factor of 2. So in general, to simplify a fraction, we remove all common factors other than 1 from the numerator and denominator. And we'll be discussing two methods for simplifying fractions in this lesson. The first method is the prime factorization method. So to simplify a fraction using the prime factorization method, step one, we factor the numerator and denominator into prime factors, and then step two, we simplify out the common factors. The second method is a divisibility method. To apply this method to simplify a fraction, we divide the numerator and denominator by the common factors until there are no longer any common factors other than one. We will be showing both methods for examples. Let's go back to that fraction of 4/6, which again, if we define the rectangle as one whole, would be modeled here. Looking at the second model, we can see that 2/3 is equivalent to 4/6, because again, the same amount of the whole is shaded, but for this model, we're using larger parts or larger pieces to represent the amount. So if we wanted to simplify 4/6 using the prime factorization method, we would write the prime factorization of 4, which is 2 times 2, and then the prime factorization of 6, which is 2 times 3. Once we have both the numerator and denominator in prime factored form, we can see the common factors that will simplify out or simplify to 1. Notice how 4 and 6 share a common factor of 2. 2 over 2 simplifies to 1, or we can think of this as 2 divided by 2. Either way, these 2's simplify to 1's. Notice now the numerator is 1 times 2 or 2, and the denominator is 1 times 3 or 3, giving us the simplified fraction of 2/3. The second method is a divisibility method, where starting with 4/6, we just look at 4 and 6, and notice they have a common factor of 2. So we divide both the numerator and denominator by 2, which gives us a simplified fraction of 2/3. Either of these two methods can be used to simplify any fraction. Let's look at another example. We're asked to write the fraction in simplest form or lowest terms. We have the fraction 3/15. So if we wanted to model 3/15, if the rectangle is one whole, we would cut or partition the rectangle into 15 equal parts or pieces, and then because the numerator is 3, we would shade 3 of them. So this is the model for 3/15. Because 3 and 5 share a common factor other than 1, this fraction will simplify, which means we can express 3/15 as an equivalent fraction using larger parts or pieces of a whole, as we see here. We can tell by the model these two fractions are equivalent because the same amount is shaded. 3/15 is equivalent to 1/5. And because 1 and 5 only have a common factor of 1, 1/5 is a simplified fraction of 3/15. But let's also show it using the prime factorization method as well as the divisibility method. So we need to find the prime factorization of 3 and 15. Well, 3 is a prime number, so the numerator stays 3. And 15 is equal to 3 times 5. Notice how we can see the common factor of 3 between the numerator and denominator. 3 over 3 or 3 divided by 3 simplifies to 1. So these 3's simplify to 1. So we're left with a 1 in the numerator, and 1 times 5 or 5 in the denominator. 1/5 is the simplified fraction of 3/15. So this is the prime factorization method. Now let's also show the divisibility method. So starting with 3/15, if we recognize that 3 and 15 share a common factor of 3, we can divide the numerator and denominator by 3, which will give us an equivalent fraction, and also the simplified fraction for 3/15. 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1. 15 divided by 3 equals 5. Let's look at one more example that's more challenging. We're asked to write the fraction 72/90 in simplified form or lowest terms. So using the prime factorization method, the first step is to find the prime factorization of 72 as well as 90. So 72 is equal to 8 times 9. 8 is equal to 2 times 4, where 2 is prime. 4 is equal to 2 times 2, both are prime. And 9 is equal to 3 times 3, both are prime. So the prime factorization of 72 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3. And now for the prime factorization of 90, we'd have 9 times 10. 9 is equal to 3 times 3, both are prime. 10 is equal to 2 times 5, both are prime. It's best to put the prime factorization in order from least to greatest. So we have 2 times 3 times 3 times 5. Now that we have the prime factorization, we can easily identify the common factors between the numerator and denominator. 2 over 2 simplifies to 1 over 1. So does 3 over 3 and 3 over 3. And now we multiply. So the numerator is 2 times 2, which is 4. The denominator is just 5. So 4/5 is the simplified fraction for 72/90. So this is the prime factorization method, which I prefer because you can actually see the common factors. The other method is the divisibility method. So starting with 72/90, let's say we recognize there's a common factor of 2. So we could divide the numerator and denominator by 2 to begin. 72 divided by 2 is equal to 36. 90 divided by 2 is equal to 45. And now from here, let's say we recognize there's a common factor of 9. So now we divide the numerator and denominator by 9. And I think we have it now. 36 divided by 9 is equal to 4. 45 divided by 9 is equal to 5. Of course, both methods yield the same result. But using the prime factorization method, we can actually see the common factors. Using the divisibility method, we must easily be able to identify any common factors. I hope you found this helpful.